Hey guys, let's cut. Hey guys, welcome to my next project. Or not project, next repairing. I had before a problem with my cruise control that I wasn't able to turn it on. So I fixed this problem in another video, and now I had another problem because my clock spring wasn't working anymore. The clock spring is built on the steering wheel and connects the buttons of the steering wheel with the car while you're turning it. And my car dealer, where I bought the car, it was a used car, but my car dealer where I bought the car before, he built a new clock spring in before he gave the car to me, or not a new one, but a second-hand clock spring, and it stopped working. So I went to my car dealer. He said go to the car electrician man. I went to the electrician man and he said, ah, no, on the second hand there's only 1 month's warranty, so it's not a warranty stuff. I said, okay, just fuck off. So I went to a used parts comp guy, and he said, ah, we don't have used spring clocks or something at the moment, but you can get a new one for $320. I said, nah, thanks, that's a bit much money for me. I don't want to spend so much money for it, because it was just the cruise control which wasn't working, the airbag and all the stuff was working. So I went online and I found a shop online shop from Tasmania, or which is in Tasmania, and they're shipping clock springs all around the world and Australia, and I paid just $100. Okay, it's an aftermarket product and not a real Nissan, but that's good enough. I have 12 months warranty, that's all I need, just $100, so that's all right. And I bought a new clock spring, and how found I out that the clock spring isn't working? Very easy. Well, not so easy, but I drove the car and tried to turn on the cruise control and it didn't work. So there wasn't any light, no light on the dashboard. Okay, so I kept driving. I thought maybe the switches are not working. I put some contact spray on them and they still didn't work. So then the other day I drove, and when I did a right turn and pushed the button, I don't know why, but I turned right, pushed the button for the cruise control to turn it on, and there was the light on, but I couldn't set the speed up. So I tried to turn it off and on, and it didn't work. Later, I turned the steering wheel to the right side, pushed the button a few times, and it always turned on and off and on and off. I did it to the left side, it didn't work. Okay, so I knew the clock spring isn't working. Afterwards, I opened the clock spring, built it out, opened it a bit, and tried to figure out what's the matter is. Maybe I can fix it, but I couldn't find any place or anything or any connection problem with the clock spring, so I decided to get a new one and to build it. And it's not a big thing, it took me only, I don't know, 10-15 minutes or so. Okay, now I did it a few times and know what I need to and how it works, but it's not a big thing. At first, somehow removing the power cable of the battery, that's not what I will do, because then it will reset my speedometer and all the stuff, and I want this in my radio and all the things, and I don't want to set up it again, so I will let it plugged in. And you have to be a bit careful with the airbag, but I think you can make it if you have some knowledge about electrician and the car stuff. So what we need to do is, it's very easy to get this airbag out. At my Golf 3 there were screws in and all the things, but here it's just clipped in, and for that we have to, before we build in the new clock spring, we have to bring the steering wheel in the straight position, or the tires in the straight position, and then we have to go underneath the steering wheel, because there is a hole. There's a hole in. Hang on, it's here, and there's a metal clip or something like a metal steel stuff. For this one, we need a flathead screwdriver, and need to push it in to get the airbag out. And what I did, because the airbag didn't come straight out, was I pushed it a bit down here. So at first I need to find the hole. That's always the trouble. For that, I hold it a bit down, not much pressure, just a little bit, that it comes straight out. Push the screwdriver in, and then you can see that it's not working. Okay, let's do it again. Yeah, so that's it. I hit it a bit here and then it jumped out. So here's the airbag. What we do at first is remove the wire on the back side, the green one here on the side. So then it's only the airbag is connected. To remove the airbag switch, airbag plug, it's not too bad. You go on the underneath the black one here, usually with a smaller screwdriver, lift the black clip up. Okay, I'll take a small. Go underneath the plug here, lift it up. It shouldn't be that hard. Why was it so easy before? Lift it up, pull it, and now it's out. So put the airbag by side. And then there's not much more to do. We only need to unplug this plug here. So there's a nose on the left side here on the bottom. Just push it in with a screwdriver, lift it up, it jumps out. So the last step we have to do is to remove this nut here, and you can see, you should see, there's a mark, and that's the mark. So that says that the steering wheel and the stuff where it's connected, the bolt, are straight and the wheels are straight. So you have to look for this one when you build it together. Now we need to open this nut. It's a 19 mil. Take a ratchet, go on top and open it. So here's the nut. Put it by side and the other stuff. What we now need to do is just to loose a bit the steering wheel. Be careful, or not anymore, because we're getting a new spring lock, but pull the airbag cable out. Put the steering wheel by side. Now we need to remove this plastic cover. So I put the steering wheel a bit down. Open the plastic here. Pull it out. Then we need the other screwdriver, the Phillips screwdriver. And there are two holes on the bottom we go through. Try to find the screw. Oh, that's a small one. That's the big screwdriver. Okay, I figured it out. It's a T25 Torx screw, so just go in, screw it out, so then we can remove this plastic and get to the second point. And for the second point, we need the Phillips screwdriver. So remove the plastic. Then we need the Phillips screwdriver, and here's one screw and there's one screw which holds the spring clock on the right position, at the right position. So we can unscrew it. So now we have to look, because there's a plug on the back side, this one. We have to remove this one, push the nose in. Maybe with a screwdriver, how I will do it. I don't know how I did it before, but just take a screwdriver. Oh. So unplug it, and there are also two plugs in my case here with a nose, which we have to push into unplug. The click spring clocks are a bit different. It depends on the model of D40 you have, but they are very similar. They are not too different, and I think you can figure it out. I think you only replace the clock spring when you know something about cars and repairing them. So plug this plugs out, and then contact. Okay. Here's on the top is also a nose.
Okay, now we have a spring clock here. It's also fixed in with one clip here on this side, where our switches are both clipped in, one side, and the other side the same. Just plug it out, and here's the new clock spring. So what we now need to do is just plug it in. Number one for light and indicator, the other one for the windscreen wiper. Just plug it in, that's it. Now we can build it in, back in, and how we pull it out, and I will show you the other steps when it's built.
We can build all together. So don't forget the plug on the top and the bolts on the bottom. So they are a bit hooked in. I don't know how important it is, but put all this stuff together. Hook them together, plug them in. So now it's done. What we now have to do is, of course, put the steering wheel in. But before we do this, there's a lock that fixes the clock spring. It's not moving while the transport and while we build it in. Now we have to remove this cap here. Remember, the wheels are still straight. So now take the steering wheel. Put the cable, it's pigtail called, in for the airbag. Put the steering wheel on and make sure that it's one line with the mark on the bolt and the steering wheel. So when this is done, plug this cable in for the buttons on the steering wheel. And now is one of the most important steps is to lock, to fix the nut. Or to fix the steering wheel, it's fixed on the yeah. So take the wrench and tie it very strong up, that you won't lose it again. Oh, not lose it again, that you won't lose the steering wheel. So now it's fixed. And next, take the airbag, plug it first, the yellow plug in, and when you want to do this, at first you have to remove this plastic, or not move it back. So like we did it before to get the plug out, pull it up. It's a little bit of a lock, and locks the switch in the airbag, that it won't get loose or lost. Plug it in, and then push the black plastic down. Now it's fixed. But next, connect the wire for the horn. Yeah, and now you can push it a bit down, and it's locked. I'm gonna turn the keys in case I find the keys. Go in the first position. The indicator are working. Windscreen wiper is working, and I can turn the cruise control on and off. Beautiful. So yeah, cruise control on, off. Beautiful, that's working. So what I now do is only put the plastic cover around the steering wheel again. And then I will go on a test drive and see if the cruise control is working, but it should be, because I can already turn it on and off. So here's the other black cover. Fill it together like you fill it out. And then you should be ready to go. The only thing is that probably your airbag light will flash in the dashboard. But I will show you how to reset it in the next video. It's not a big thing. I will make another video. So just take a look in my channel, look, search for it, and you will find it, how to reset the airbag lamp in a Navara D40. And yeah, then we go. And I'll let you know after my test drive if the cruise control and everything is working. Okay guys, I just came back from my test drive and everything is working. So my lights are working, my indicators, my windscreen wiper, I checked this all. So the spring clock is alright, and what I did is alright, I didn't damage anything and everything is fine. So I hope it helped you and you had some inspiration, and I think you can make it. Just be careful with the airbag and the cable, that you not break any cable or something, because then you have the next problem. So yeah, if you liked it, like the video and like and subscribe to keep up to date and see what's new on my channel. And see you next week for my next project or my next thing I will repair, fix or anything. And yeah, see you there. Have a good week and a good time at work, and don't forget, have a beer or a wine and enjoy your work and what you did, and be proud about you, because you made it and you made it right and everything works. Cheers and see ya.